It's been over 2 months since we last saw official images from the filming of Uncharted. Now the time has come again because the social media team published 4 new pictures to get us in the mood for the blockbuster, which is scheduled for release in mid-July. Especially interesting is a picture of a mysterious gold cross which is covered with precious stones and could possibly serve as a key. Could this be the key to the golden city of El Dorado? Also interesting is the world map on which some places are marked in red. Among them are Scotland, Iceland, Crete, the Red Sea, and coastal areas of Australia and Antarctica. This seems quite plausible after all we're used to Nathan Drake being able to master any terrain from snowy mountain peaks to overgrown jungles and dry deserts. Africa is clearly at the center of it all, which in turn could indicate the main location of the story. Which is also noticeable is that Australia is missing a large part of the landmass, which is why the map must be a few centuries old. Of course, it's still up in the air whether the locations mentioned will actually be in the upcoming film, but they will most likely have some connection to the storyline. Regardless, we are excited to see new material and we look forward to the release on July 16th, 2021. After the surprise hit Alita Battle Angel from 2019, there were not necessarily any obvious signs of a sequel. Financially, the film delivered solid box office results, but not so outstanding that one directly announces a second part. In the meantime, there has even formed an Alita Army among the most loyal fans, which has achieved, amongst other things, that the film was re-released in the US at the end of October. Whether the enthusiasm of a few fans is enough to persuade Fox owner Disney to produce Part 2 is unclear. At least leading actress Rosa Salazar and Christoph Waltz would definitely be interested in a return. At the end of December, director Robert Rodriguez revealed that a sequel to Alita Battle Angel may not be unrealistic, especially in the Disney Plus realm. He himself would also be keen to make the second part a reality. However, whether this is in line with his schedule is quite questionable because the director has just secured the Netflix project We Can Be Heroes and has also been confirmed as one of the producers of the Mandalorian spin-off The Book of Boba Fett. Thus, it seems that Alita Battle Angel 2 is not a top priority. The Resident Evil franchise already has 6 films to its name. The dubious common factor of all films so far has been that they had little to do with the original video games. That's about to change with the latest spin-off, however, as director Johannes Roberts has focused on the plot of the first game and completed filming just over a week ago. The canon is about a group of the STARS unit that is supposed to investigate the Spencer Mansion in Raccoon City. Jill Valentine, Leon Kennedy, Chris Redfield, and Claire Redfield are supposed to be part of the team. In addition to differences in content, the new reboot is supposed to stand out by focusing much more on the horror component than the action one. The expected release date of the Resident Evil reboot is September 10th, 2021. Oh, by the way, there is a danger of mix-ups with a simultaneously produced Resident Evil Netflix series, which is also supposed to be kind of a reboot, but has nothing to do with the video games. The series is actually about Albert Wesker's children who are investigating a mystery in New Raccoon City. Further Netflix series about Claire Redfield and Leon Kennedy is also in the works and will be called Resident Evil Infinite Darkness. Justice League hero Cyborg, played by Ray Fisher, will not be appearing with The Flash in the film by the same name after all. This might have come as a surprise a few weeks ago, but after the public dispute between Fisher and the Warner executives, the matter is now clear. The disputes already began in Joss Whedon's Justice League times when Fisher publicly accused the director of disgusting, offensive, and unprofessional behavior. Warner and DC Films executives also got their comeuppance as they were blamed for covering Whedon's behavior as well. At the end of last year, Fisher again made statements about DC Films President Walter Hamada calling him a liar regarding the investigation of Whedon's behavior at the time. To top it all off, Fisher affirmed that as long as Hamada was in office, he would no longer work for DC. As it has now been announced, Hamada's contract has been extended until 2023, which rules out any collaboration with Ray Fisher in the near future. A replacement for the upcoming The Flash movie currently does not seem to be planned, so what will happen with other DC movies in the future is yet to be seen. The release date of The Flash is on November 4th, 2022, under the direction of IT director Andy Muschietti. Back in 2015, the Rocky franchise was brought back to life with a spin-off, Creed. The lead actor Michael B. Jordan plays the son of Rocky's companion Apollo Creed, who is trained by none other than Rocky Balboa himself. As was now revealed a few days ago in an MTV interview with Tessa Thompson, Jordan will henceforth not only take over the lead role but also the direction of Creed 3. Therefore, he directly falls in the footsteps of Sylvester Stallone, who also took over his role and the direction at the same time from the second Rocky part. Jordan will not be left alone with his demanding task because on the one hand, he has the experienced Sylvester Stallone at his side, on the other hand, the previous director Ryan Coogler continues to work with him as a producer. According to Tessa Thompson, there is no hurry either, because filming is not scheduled to start before the end of this year. A release date for Creed 3 could then realistically be announced at the end of 2022.